So the next part of this video, we wanted to explain the umaha bustle. And so they call this the khage, X-A-X-E. It's very guttural. And so what this translates into, it actually acknowledges the crow. And so they call this the crow belt. And the crow belt is made up of many different relatives that exist outside. And so once again, the circle is the second battle. These feathers on the outside are actually eagle feathers. And then the inside. So the next row, and another row, and another row. And so there's actually four rows. This is the hawk. This is the owl, and this is the crow. And so once again, these are all meat eaters. And so this is the second battlefield. Long ago, they would fight in midair. That's how birds fight. That's how birds mate. Everything is done in midair. And so they're attacking each other. And so they have huge talons, bigger than my hands, just grabbing and trying to grab each other and try to force them down to the ground. And so in doing so, all of these feathers are falling out, right? And so once again, these birds are fighting over what was left on the battlefield. And so the common item that is in every single bustle is a trailer. On this side, this trailer is green. On this side, it's red. And once again, as they went into this battlefield, that prairie grass was just nice and beautiful and green. After the fight, after everything was done, this is all the blood that was spilt and that was tracked into that grass and onto that land. And so that's why this side is always red. We always acknowledge every single one of our relatives who lost their lives during these battles. And so a commonality of every bustle is we would have feathers on every trailer, and every single feather represents a deceased warrior that was left on that battlefield. And so that's why we have these feathers. And so once again, these are all birds of prey that are going to feast on the cartage, on the meat that is left. Sometimes it's from the two-leggeds. Sometimes it's from the four-leggeds, the horse, the dogs, whatever else. And so whatever is in this perimeter here was fair game. And so they would fight. And so every single bustle, every single feather wasn't all pretty and this and that. Not like today. And so these older bustles, after they tied their feathers, because of the fights, they would get their feathers and just ruffle it up like this. And so that's common. And so every single one of these, this part of these feathers, these are called barbs. And if you barely pull them, they're trying to hold on to each other because they have like these little baby thorns that you can't even see unless you have a microscope. And so when you want to preen them, this is called preening, when you get your feather and you put it back together again, because I can ruffle it up and see how it all separates the barbs. But if I preen it, the barbs that are on each one of these will actually grab onto each other again and make that feather all nice and beautiful. And so this is preening. So, once again, since this is a battlefield, there was arrows that were in play. And so every bustle has arrows. Today we call them the spikes. Here are the spikes. So every part of a wing has the primary. The primary usually has 10 feathers, and that's what these feathers are. So this is the primary, this is the secondary. And so most of our bustles are actually made from the secondary because we're making round bustles. This primary, when I get a bird, I'll cut that primary part off of that bird. And once again, just like a chicken leg, just like our arm, this joint right here, that wing has that same joint. And so I cut right at that joint. I'll keep these 10 feathers. I'll spread them out just like Miss Bradley did, and I will dry them. But I will leave them on there for like 4 to 5, 6 months. And that cartilage inside there will harden and dries up, and that eagle fan will stay like that forever. And so if you ever go to a powwow and you see our dancers with that big old eagle fan, that means that somebody knew how to take care of that wing, to cut it at that joint, to spread it out nicely and evenly, and then patiently wait up to 6 months for it to dry, to harden. And then we put a buckskin handle on it, and that's our eagle fans that we use today. So when I talk about this bustle, once again, these spikes represent the arrows that are stuck into the bodies in this battlefield. And for Umaha bustles, their bustles are very special and very unique. And here's why. And so this is called the crow belt. And for the longest time, when people seen this bustle, they associated that bustle with the Crow Nation. But that's not the truth. The truth is, for the Umaha people, there is a warrior society called the Heluska. One of their most prized possessions, an insignia. And so if you look at the military, you look at the ribbons and the medals and everything else that are placed on the chest of our warriors, those are insignias. That's exactly what this bustle is. Because back in the day, there was only 4 people gifted this bustle amongst the Umaha people. And so today, this bustle has spread all over the world. But back in the day, you had to prove yourself. You had to be one of the 4 that were gifted this badge of honor, this insignia. And so that's how special this bustle actually is. And so these are the feathers of the eagle, the hawk, the owl, the crow. And so on this side, they would always have a big old wolf tail. And the reason why is because the Umaha people were fighting this other tribe, and they didn't know where they were. And so they asked Shugumanitu. Shugumanitu is the wolf. They asked him, can you go into that encampment and spot them and then come back and tell us? Because back in the day, we were able to communicate with the four-legged and the winged relatives and the water relatives, because we lived outside with them. We lived amongst them. And so we became very familiar with their language, their customs, their traditions, and movement. And so we would mimic, we would talk to them in their own language. And so we asked this wolf, this Shugumanitu, to go back out once again, to be the scout. But that other tribe that was warring against the Umaha people knew that that wolf was a scout. And so the first thing they did was they pulled out their arrows and they killed him. And the wolf never made it back home. And so on this side, the next day, they kept waiting for this wolf and he never returned. And so they figured it out. They're like, those people must have figured out that that was our spy. And so they asked another relative, the crow. And that's why this is called the crow belt. They asked the crow to go out and fly amongst the people. And he's like, well, what if they see me and they shoot me, you know, because I'm a spy. And they were like, just fly higher so their arrows can't touch you. And he goes, when I come back, how are you going to know that it's me? And they said, hold your wing out. And they spread his wing out and they clipped one of his feathers. So in flight, when they seen him flying, they could see that that feather was gone. And they're like, oh, that is our kage, our kola, our friend. And so he's making his way back. And so from that time on, that crow made his way onto this bustle. Except when we placed this crow on this bustle, we left him intact. That's his tail feathers. These are his wings. And so his head, we turned it around and we laid the beak in between the two back feathers. And the reason why is because he was always watching this warrior's back. And so that was his set of eyes in the back. And so that warrior could always advance forward. And so this was his protector. And so that's really cool. And so this is why this is called the crow belt of the Umaha people. Once again, these are the spikes, the arrows in the bodies. These are the rows of feathers that are attached inside of each other to make this conical shape of these different relatives. And then once again, every trailer was green and red because the blood was spilled. Every trailer has feathers hanging down, and these represent the fallen warriors. This is the spy that never came back. This is the wolf tail. And the crow. And so everything is tied to a backboard. A backboard looks like this, made out of rawhide. Has holes on the side, and we loop it together because it's actually one big piece that we fold over. And so then we place holes right here, and we have wires or something sticking up in there, sticks. And this is how we attach our eagle feathers to represent the spikes and the arrows. On the bottom, we have holes, and we have a stick that goes across. On the stick, that holds the two trailers. This is our backboard. And so this is the story of the Umaha bustle. Thank you.